what collapsed the first wheel. Now we're going to do the exact same that we did here, right here, and then connect them up, then connect these creases, and then that is all this bottom part done. And it's basically the same over here. Yep, so if you've not already, make this mountain fold, this red one here. Now you can see all the lines line up correctly. And make the mountain fold. And this bit's quite confusing. Right, we'll come back to that bit last. I'm not sure what to do with that. No, that's blue, that's fine. I thought I'd missed the red line. No, I've not. So make this mountain fold all the way up. Ah, it stops there, so yeah. Then this one as well, going up. I'll pick that up. Yes. Now we can start to puff out these level shifters. Thank you. it up. Just like that. Now I can puff out these shutters better. Then the mounting folds. This one's going to be quite tricky. Fold up and then fold it over. Yeah, because that's a valley fold. That's a mount fold as well. I'll do it just now, I can undo it later if I need to. It's just so I can get this level shifter in place. Just mount and put this valley fold in. Then see how the creases line up. Mount and fold this inside. So push it inside. And then you'll see, I don't know, how can you, yeah, you can see it from there. Mount and fold, the mount and fold. That's going to get pushed up inside it. Like that. Now we're going to extend these creases. Yep, so the valley fold, mountain fold, valley fold, mountain fold, to help try and flatten this bit out more. So these ones here. Take them away just now. I really want to get this one in place as well, so I'm going to try and force it in place. Right, I'll extend this down the middle. So that's in place, and this is in place, just like that. And I'm going to peg it right at the top. Do this crease here, this mountain fold. Just trying to get this bit to lie flat. In fact, we'll do these ones. So this mountain fold, I'm going to extend it to here and then here, and this one's going to get pushed underneath. Basically just like how you did this part here on the wheel, it's the same principle, because you've got the mountain fold here. Thank you. So you're going to make this valley fold, then this mountain fold, and push it over enough so these mountain folds and valley folds line up. See, I've got my finger here pushing up. I'm going to push over, then over, and it's going to lock in place. Then I'll reinforce the crease. That's the valley fold. Yep. Mountain fold. Now it's just a matter of trying to get it to lie flat. I'm going to peg it here just now, just to hold it in place. While trying, I can remove this one. So this mountain fold, which is... Where is it? This one here. This needs to be a right angle on this one, so it's going to push this one out as well. And this is what I mean right here. So you've got the right angle, right angle. So this pushes this mountain fold out. Turn that together. That's a valid fold as well. Valid fold. Oh yeah, that's a the mountain fold, so it must. You see this mountain, valley, mountain. These all get pushed together and then curved, because this line here, these two blocks are the side of the vehicle. This is where the vehicle turns to be the edge of it, the end of it actually. That's it. So I'm going to fold all these layers up again. You see? They're all that fold. That one's a mountain fold, but I have no idea what you do here. double mountain folds. Anyway, it doesn't matter. I'm pretty sure it doesn't matter. So squash all together and then valley fold it. And that's the bottom of the beagle. These are the last two units at the end. Then this is the back. And the mountain fold, is this supposed to turn round? Oh, it's a swivel. So you see this mountain fold? Maybe fold this down and then round. Then that's double valley fold. No. Again, it doesn't really matter, to be honest. So I'll show you the close-ups of this part we just did, because it was quite confusing. The wheel, and I'll show you again from a different angle just in case it helps you. So everything we did here is basically the exact same right here, but we'll get right. So we've collapsed the both wheels on one side. This part here is the last part we're going to collapse. This is the very basically everything else needs to be in place. So when you fold this mountain fold over, everything lines up, then comes neatly together. But that's last, so we can forget about that. We're going to make the wheels on this side. So we should have stopped. Yep. Try and bring this round, that's better. So again, make the mountain fold. And then we've got this mountain fold here. Make this one. And then the same with this one here. And then peg right here. You don't need to peg it, but it just helps it. Helps to collapse everything. Right, now we can start making these mountain folds again. Going all the way around. That's a valley fold. these lines will connect up with the ones we did in part one. So make this a mountain fold and then the valley fold. So that's these lines here. There's the valley fold, the mountain, the valley, and these ones. They'll connect up together. I'm going to peg it here as well, just to hold this bit in place. Yeah. We'll come back to this, but I'm not sure how this collapses. Oh. No, that's it. So like that, that's it. I'll unfold that so you can see. Right, I'll peg that there. And then, how does this bit collapse? So it folds up, you see? So we need to make this mountain fold here, going right round the rectangle or the square. In fact, I'll unpeg that one actually. I think it's a closed, yeah, that's a closed sink, this bit here. Which part is this? Crease part. Right here. It's a closed sink. So, So have these in place first, these main mountain and valley folds. I think I just screwed up there. Then pinch it, then make this valley fold. Then you see the lines line up, the colours line up, and then close sync. Yep, that's it. That is it. And then push it down. Push down. Let's try and bring all this together and then we can move on. Should we do this bit now? Yep, so like that. Right here. That's what it should look like. Right, we'll make the wheels now. Make both wheels. And that should make it easier to collapse. So first, I'll start off over this thing. So make the mountain fold, fold it over the way. And then make this level shifter. Like that, because this part is the teeth, so this is the teeth right here, and what I did to make them was just do an LS stretch. I think that's how you make them, but that's what I did, and it worked out, so we're going to do that later on, if we make it that far, hopefully. Right. Make these mountain folds again, just like over here. Bring this over the way, over here. So the colours line up. In fact, I'll peg it right there. Right, now the colours. Oh. Now the colours line up right here. Like that. That. Now we can make the mountain valley folds going across. And then again, make this mountain fold and this one as well. So this mountain fold and then this one here, and fold them inwards like the previous wheels. I better change the battery in a second, it's going to die on it. But I'll just do it now. Right, let's continue with these wheels. The same as before. Move that up a wee bit. Get this mountain fold in place first. Oh, shouldn't I get so much? I feel sick. Why is this not working? That's why that line wasn't in place. So that's down. Yep. Thank you. Now I'm going to make these ones to make this easier to collapse here and here. There we go. This bit's not in place. These level shutters. Now bring this edge and this edge together, which will help line up these creases, and then you can flatten all out. It's probably easier if you lie it flat down, and you can do it this way. Oh, it's proven to be a nuisance. There we go. Although it's not. It's not perfect, but take your time when you do it, make sure it's right, make sure it's spot on. And then we'll do this one as well. Take this out of the way so I can see what I'm doing. Oh, he's level shifter, so that's what's wrong. And this part again, right here, is what we did earlier on. Right here, it's the exact same method. so let's do that for now so we can finish collapsing this. Oh, how is it you do it again? It's the other side. Nope. Again, so make this the mountain fold, then this the valley fold. So we're going to have to try and force it all together. That's right, I can't remember. Yep. I'm missing a crease. What's this way? Ah, I'm missing a crease, another line. This bit here is a valley fold. It's supposed to be blue. That's alright, I was getting worried there. What about this one here? That's nothing. Now let's try and force it all together. Oh, there we go. Here's a slight flop. What does this crease do? This one under it. Alright, that gets tucked underneath. So how does this work again? Oh, like that and that. That's a swivel. No, I like that. I don't know how well you can see it. It looks good from the camera view. So right here, this top layer goes over, this goes under, so like that, and then pinch, close over, make the valley fold and mountain fold. Put that wee swivel in place as well. I can force this down. Get rid of this. I can make these creases now. There we go, that's lying flat. Oh, that's not fully submerged then. Now I can unpeg that. I don't know why this isn't lying flat. But it doesn't matter anyway. I can peg the whole lot. In fact, I'll make the creases strong first, and then I'll undo it so you can see exactly what I did. So to do this correctly, get your level shifters in place first, get the mountain folds in, and then do the sink folds right here, because you need to bring the layers together and then push this inside the gap, and then bring the mountain folds over, bring the paper together, and then squash it together to lie it flat. There you go. Of course, make sure you do it perfect so no bits stick out like this. Again, it doesn't matter, you can just force it in to hide it if you need to. Right, it's getting quite dark, so I'm going to stop just now.